Some of us was on a hospital bed and we got up off the hospital bed because of the grace and mercy. Come on, thank Him for His grace and mercy. Don't everybody look nice? Hallelujah. Everybody looking holy? Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're going to go ahead and get started. Amen? Amen. We might as well start off, God, because we just like the man of God said, once we start moving around, the Holy Ghost comes in, it gets warm in here. Amen. You won't be cold. Hallelujah. You won't even be lukewarm. Can I get an amen? But you'll be hot with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Come on, brother. Hit them drums, brother. Can we shout a little bit? Come on, come on, clap your hands, y'all. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, clap. Here we go, y'all. I don't know what you come to do. I don't know what you come to do.
I don't know what you come to do.
You and you and you and you.
You and you and you and you.
I can't clap my hands.
My hands.
I can't stop my feet.
My feet.
I can't jump for joy.
For joy.
I can't praise the Lord. Praise in. Nine. It's Holy Ghost time. Eight.
ain't no jive. Four, come on, let's praise the Lord some more. Three, it's you, Jesus and me. I said two, come on, this one for you. One, guess what, y'all? We ain't done. 60 more seconds, come on.
To be praised. Amen. Amen. And now we're going to have a scripture from our own Deacon Smith. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hello, everybody. So happy to be with you today.
Amen. Amen. What a glorious day it is.
Amen.
Celebration. 39 years.
39 years.
God is good.
All the time.
I'm going to read scripture this morning from 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, and I'll read verses 12 through 14, and it reads, "For as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ.
Yeah.
For by one Spirit we are all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit. For the body is not one member, but many." Amen.
Amen.
The Lord has blessings to readers, to hearers, and doers of his holy word.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Great moment in our church life. Amen? And now it's time we can all come together and just have a little talk with the Lord. Amen? Now, Lord. Now, God. Now, my one and only. My one and only God, the only one I have need for, because I heard you supply all of my needs. And I just thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you for just being you. And you alone, Lord. Thank you. Then I thank you for your son, Father, that you sent, Father, to go to that old rugged cross, in my presence, to take on my sins, that one day, I'll be with you in your holy kingdom. And I thank you, Lord. Father, I thank you for your Holy Spirit. Come in now and lead and guide me, to keep me on that right path with you, Father, to teach me your ways, Father, that I might live in your way. And I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. Father, I thank you for my pastor and my first lady. You sent me to come in, lead and guide us, to keep us once again on that holy, that path with you, Father God. Oh, Father, I just thank you. I thank you, Lord. And in this congregation that you've given me to fellowship with, Father, I thank you, Lord. And in this day, Father, we come to celebrate your church, not my church, not the pastor's church, but your church. Celebrate you, Father. Because it's what you did. You made it so we could come with one another and praise you by your Son, Father. That now we know. Now we know that we have a chance at everlasting life. We didn't come to give praise to this building. You're not coming back for a building. You're coming back for your church. But I'm spot on blessing. This old building ain't gonna make it. Because now we are new. We're a new faith in Him. All our sins have been cast away by Him.
I'm tired. I worked late last night.
You got a busy week coming this week. Raise your hand if you got a test on Monday, a quiz on Monday. Raise your hand if you got to pay a bill tomorrow you really don't want to pay. Raise your hand if you got to make a call tonight or tomorrow you really don't want to make the call.
Amen.
Put your hand in front of your face, everybody. Take a deep breath. Let it out. Guess what? That's your reminder that I'm still keeping you through all that you just experienced. Amen. So no matter what we go through, we are here because we are on one accord.
Amen.
We are here to celebrate not this building, not the people in the building, but we are here to celebrate Christ. We are here to celebrate God and His church. So if you are ready to come aboard this celebration, welcome. Amen, everybody. How you feeling?
Amen.
So I get too excited and forget these. So welcome again. We are going to have an official welcome. But as you know, my name is Dr. Nicole Dobbins, and I am your minister of ceremonies this evening to Faith Bible Christian Center, our 39th anniversary.
Amen.
That's not
Amen.
And I say we can celebrate 39, but the Lord's had the church around for a lot longer than that. So it's really a celebration of us coming into agreement with what the Lord wants us of us. So that's what we're celebrating. The church, God's chosen people.
Amen.
But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should shew forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. First Peter, second and ninth. It just called you to shout out.
Amen.
The one that called you out has called you to shout out and celebrate. Hallelujah. For what I have brought you through that breath that I give to keep you. So as you know, today we are going to be honored by words from the throne by Pastor Slack.
Amen.
But prior to we getting to that, we're going to make sure that your spirit is open and ready to receive the word that God has for each and every one of us. So first, we are going to have a selection by our own Minister of Music, Dwayne Anderson, our Faith Bible Christian Center praise dancers. And then we are going to go into an occasion and welcome by our own sister, Charlene Watson. And following that, we are asking for a visitor's response. Now, I love to say this in our church, and I'm going to say it again. I already know it. Are y'all fired up?
Yeah.
There we go. All right.
Amen. Come and clap your hands for Minister Nikki. Preacher, teacher, professor. Amen.
Amen.
She does it all. And everything. How many people want to be holy in here?
Amen. Yes.
Come, it's a matter of life and death. Can I get an amen that we be
amen.
Holy? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
You know, sometimes you get you gotta realize it's a matter of life and death. Yet you gotta be holy. So the kids are as the children are coming in, and my wife and everything, we want to minister to you. And this song is called Holy. It was a song that I wrote when I was in the darkest days of my life. Amen.
Amen.
And God kept me even through that storm. When
Amen.
You know that storm, when you think you're going to die, amen. And that storm, you don't see no way out. You reach up your hand, touching up but bottom type of storm, amen. But you reach a little hand a little higher, and God will grab your hand and pull you out of that situation. Anybody been there? Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So let this song minister. If you like worship and if you love to worship God, let this song minister to your mind, heart, and spirit with holy, amen. As the children are coming, where are the children? And while we're at that, can you put your hands together for yourself for coming out here? This is a nice crowd. Come on, y'all. Hallelujah. Awesome. Miraculous. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And anybody ready to see a miracle today? Amen.
Amen.
I'm looking for signs, wonders, and a miracle. What about y'all? Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Here they come. Amen. Come on, clap your hands for the children as they come in. Amen. Remember, this is holy. Amen. Hallelujah. Let this song minister to your mind, heart, and soul, and spirit. Holy Ghost, come on, move me out of the way. Whatever's in me that's not of you, cast it out so that I can minister to your people in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Nothing but the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood, the precious blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I spend most of my time humbling myself and laying down on my face, worshiping God and honoring God in the secret place. I got a relationship.
relationship with Jesus Christ, my Lord, because I move myself out of his way. I got a closer walk with God. In my obedience, I fast and pray, because I got to be holy. How many people need to be holy? Come on.
Holy.
I need to be holy and righteous. See, the devil can't stop me from being. See, the world can't stop me from being. Jesus, won't you help me to be holy and righteous? And when I surrender to God's will and surrender to God's way, I apply the word of God to my life. And even when I pray, and then I ask God to cover me with his blood, then I anoint my own self on the head. I go and testify how Jesus died and rose from the dead. And then I get down on my knees at the altar and intercede that God's word goes forth in every church and all through the land, through all four corners of this earth. And then I pray to God to encamp his angels in this holy place. And then I pray for wisdom and humility that I can finally see God's face, because I gotta be
holy.
Oh, Jesus, I gotta be
holy
and righteous.
Holy.
Now listen, y'all. The devil can't stop me from being. The world can't stop me from being. Jesus, won't you help me to be holy and right? Now you might as well take your shoes off, y'all. Take them off.
Holy,
one body, one church. Holy, if you got legs, come on. no matter what you're going through. Gotta be
holy.
Come on, Holy Spirit. I worship you. Come on, clap your hands. Because we have to strive to be holy. Can I get an amen, y'all?
Amen, amen.
Hallelujah. Is there anybody in here who wants to be holy?
Yes, Lord.
Is there anybody in here who wants to be holy?
Yes, Lord.
The question is, are you ready? Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord, saints. It's good when the believers can come into in the house of the Lord and give God all the praise, the honor, and the glory.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, my God. It's good to see the saints in the house of the Lord. See, this is just a rehearsal. But when we get to heaven, it's going to be all about giving God the praise. So give him the praise. Clap your hands. Give him the praise. Oh, Lord, thank you. Yes, Lord. First, give an honor to God and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. To Pastor William, First Lady Lulu William, the pastor in the pulpit, FBBC members, and guests. I come this evening want to give you a welcome along with the pastor and the First Lady and the FBCC members. Whatever you feel like doing, if you feel like shouting, shout. If you like saying amen, say amen.
Amen.
But it's not about us. It's about God. It's about
amen.
Lifting up
amen.
His name. Lifting up his holy name. Because he's all-knowing. He say, I am that I am. I am the bright morning star. I am the way maker. Who believes that he's a healer? He'll give you the peace in the time of the storm. Yes, Lord. He's all-knowing God, all-powerful God. And we just want to welcome you here this evening for our 39-year church anniversary. Help us to lift the name of Jesus. Like I can say, it's not about us, but it's all about Jesus.
Amen.
We welcome you.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Pastor, first lady, and to you, my sisters and brothers in Christ. No, I am not going to sing.
I guess.
Well, I bring you greetings from New Paradise in the absence of our pastor. As you know, he had a heart attack and two deaths immediately afterwards. Mm-hmm. So that's why. But we do have some of our members here.
Amen.
And we're just honored to be here. And thank you so much for inviting us.
Amen.
If I may, sister, can you tell everyone, how is your pastor doing today?
Amen.
As far as from what I understand, I believe he's recovering.
He is doing well.
He had to go out of town to his aunt's funeral.
But But the Lord is doing a work in his life, and he is blessed for what he experienced. We want to claim the victory for the healing, the miracle that we know the Lord shown through him. So thank you for coming, and thank you for your presence, and thank you for your prayers, and just thank you for being in agreement with all of us. Amen. As we are with you. We will now move down to our ministry of giving. Okay. And we are now leaving it into the hands of our junior ushers that are going to come forth. Mm-hmm. Respond.
This is the tithes and offering basket. Please stand the direction of the usher in back.
Training, and we're training him. So everybody say amen, and all right, he's all right. Sometimes as believers, and really all the time, we have to put aside our form and stance. What we have come to expect and think should occur and allow the Lord to occur. Sometimes we get in the way. We have junior ushers, and one is really, this is his first time. Amen. So he's learning. And they're all learning, and one is learning how to coach the other, and one is learning how to receive feedback from the other, and it's a part of growth. And we honor that. But it's funny, you know, when things don't go the way they should, that's when your true faith shows up.
Amen.
Amen. So now we are going to be blessed again by another praise dance from our own Pastor Mary. Okay.
I told God yes. I was eager to do what he told me to in obedience. Looking out in the crowd, I see eyes closed, tears falling, hands lifted, people praising and worshiping too. They didn't see me, they only saw you. It felt good, but something was missing. See, I'm empty inside, and I'm wondering why. Will I ever feel what they felt from me? I didn't know the price of yes. Would cost me so much.
I've been broken and bruised, hey. Wondering will I still use, crying out to you, got nothing left to lose. Father, hear my plea, need you to
broken.
I've been broken and bruised, wondering will God still use, crying out to you, got nothing left to lose. Father, hear my plea, need you to rescue me, 'cause I'm broken.
Something to say, not sure where I start. I'm afraid to begin, it's all falling apart. See, I thought because I was working for you, everything wrong you would undo, but it wasn't quite true. It's hard to admit that I can't feel you like
'cause I'm in ministry and I'm messed up. I'm confused with no one to talk to. I need a breakthrough. I need a breakthrough. Cause this is the thing you've anointed me to do.
I'm broken. Wondering will God steal you?
I'm crying out to you. To do for me. Now that you're broken, he says there's a lie left in you to do for me. Now that you're broken. Oh, I hear you. Say, how could you use me when you know this and that about me? But there's a lot left in you.
Amen.
broken.
Yes, yes, yes.
No matter how broken I may feel, no matter what you may think of me, there is more inside that God has for me. Amen. Let's give them another hand, please. And now we are going to go back in our history, and we are going to have a presentation by one of our, I'm waiting for it to look at me, one of our oldest members. And oldest meaning respected, wise, funny, jovial, will correct you in a heartbeat, but that's because she loves the Lord. And so when she comes and reads these words to you, understand the passion that comes behind it. It's not just reading a script. So at this time, Sister Ruby Lewis.
Good afternoon, church. Giving honor to God, who is the head of, ahead of my life, to the pulpit, and to all of my sisters and brothers in Christ. 39 years. I was young, tender. But 39 years later, I'm old and rough. And I just want to thank God for wherever he had brought me. I got new glasses. Well, on January 19, 1986, Faith Bible Christian Center received its commission and started holding service in a storefront on Las Vegas Boulevard under the leadership of Billy H. Casey and seven families. After only 8 months, God tremendously blessed the church, and Faith Bible Christian Center relocated to Webster Street. And 1992, Pastor Billy Casey was led to pastor a church in North Carolina. Faith Bible Christian Center continued under the leadership of Minister Corsi, Minister Davis, and Minister Arnold. In July of 2001, Minister Vernon Williams was elected as pastor of Faith Bible Christian Center and appointed Minister Willie Watson as the assistant pastor and Deacon Rufus McKinney, who is now with the Lord. Willie Watson is too, praise the Lord. The Lord has blessed Faith Bible Christian Center tremendously. We still have one of the its founding members, yours truly. Used to be 10, oh no. We were blessed in February 2002 with 19 members to purchase our existing facility here at 1904 Stevens. On April 7, 2002, our sanctuary dedication service was held. Service then has purchased and paved the parking lot and made numerous improvements and upgrade to our property with his continued blessing. In July of 2017, we paid our final payment on this property. On December the 10th, 2017, our first baby dedication service was held for Emmanuel Adam, child and legs. God is not finished with us yet. But I would like to say that our church, when Pastor Casey and his family started the church, he was a parole officer. And he saw so many of our children coming into the system. And he, by starting a church, he figured he could and have them to come and have some place to go. You know, it's okay to be of the system, but he didn't want to see them in the system. And since then, our youth have grown, and I would like to thank our pastor because he spent a lot of time and money, Lou, making sure that our youth understand that there is always a place in the house of the Lord. Amen. I'm going to leave that for now.
Amen. She's coming back for round two. How's everybody feeling?
Yes.
Good. All right. All right. Please remember, if you need anything as you're sitting, we do have the ushers in the back. Just alert them to your presence if there's anything that you may need. We are now going to have, and we are so thankful that he is able to be with us today in terms Amen. Of words of encouragement, Pastor Ezra Bell from Fresh Start Baptist Church.
Amen. 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 39 years. Amen. You know, when they said that the property had been paid off, I believe it was 2017, I think she said, that should have been a round of applause. Amen. There. Let's get God some praise for that. Hallelujah. Amen. Too often we fail to celebrate those important things. Amen. And so God has allowed them to pay that off. But 39 years. First of all, you just thank God for allowing us to be able to come out to help you all celebrate this momentous day. Pastor Byrne and Sister Lulu, we know you all are always such hard workers. Amen. Over here, and we just want to thank God for you all and Faith Bible. Pastor Slack, we're just looking forward to hearing a word from you. Told him in a study that each time he speaks, I learn so much. Woo! Amen. And so I'm just looking forward. I got my pen ready so we can take some notes. And it's one of those things when you have a great teacher like that you can learn some things. And I'm not one of those ones who will not plagiarize. Yeah, if I hear it and it sounds good, I'm going to jot it down, and I'm going to use it. Amen. I'm going to use it. And so I'm just looking forward to hearing him as he put it out. I'm writing it down. I'm writing it down. And you all that cook, you know how you get a recipe and you add your own little flavoring to it? And they say, boy, she sure made a, you know, good potato salad or a good peach cobbler or something, because it might have been mama's recipe, but you added some flavor to it. And so, Pastor Slack, as you preach the word, I'm going to jot your recipe down. But somewhere along the line, I'm going to have to use it. Amen. Pastor Hale's always great to see you, and we just thank God. But just by way of words of encouragement, you know, you think about this, God's chosen people. And 39 years ago, God chose you. 39 years ago, God chose you. And through the thick and through the thin, God has been using you. But I'm convinced that we're in a home stretch. The churches are in a home stretch. And every church, I really believe, we're in that critical, critical moment. Mm-hmm. At Faith Bible, God has blessed you to see 39 years, but it's crunch time now. Yeah, it's crunch time now. The scripture says that you are a chosen generation, that God has called you for such a time as this. You know, we're living in a time now where in our schools, they're teaching boys and girls where you might not be what you were born. You know, we're living in a time where crime is so rampant. We're living in a time where it's almost a crime to tell somebody about the Lord. And so we're at a time where we're in that critical, critical moment. And Faith Bible, God has spared you 39 years, but now he's saying, roll your sleeves up. Amen. Roll your sleeves up. Mm-hmm. Because the battle is getting ready to get rough.
Amen.
But the good news is he called you. Mm-hmm. The good news is he called you. And not only did he call you, but he equipped you. Mm-hmm. He equipped him. When you get to Ephesians 4:11 and you go in and you read that particular passage, and God will tell you who all he gave to the church. But he equipped you. Mm-hmm. He's equipped you. He's given you all you need to be able to get out there and do what thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
Now don't worry about how they want to talk about you. Don't matter how they want to throw roadblocks up. You know what? Just keep on working for the Lord.
Amen.
Just realize he's brought you this many years. He's not going to leave you. Yeah, he's not going to leave you. So he's called you, and he's equipped you.
Amen.
But the last thing I want to encourage you with is this. Not only did he call you, not only did he equip you, but he's kept you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yeah, he's kept you. So, you know, you think about that, and you go into Matthew in that 28th chapter, and when he instructed the church to go out into all the world, go out there and preach the word and make disciples. Right. But he summed it all up, and he simply said, but lo, I'm with you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he said, no matter what comes along, I am with you. And so he's kept you thus far. And guess what? I just trust God enough to know he's going to keep you all the way. Whatever God starts, he would start a good thing. Don't you know he's able to keep that all the way until our Lord returns? And I believe that when that time comes, when God comes and he says, it's time now to usher in that great tribulation. Mm-hmm. And he looks around and he says, Faith Bible, it's time for me now to pull you out of here. Mm-hmm. Pastor Slack, he's going to look over where you are and say, it's time for me to pull you all out of there. Faith, and he's going to look over at Fred, so it's time to pull you out all out. Because those churches that have been faithful to him, he says, I'm coming to present to myself a church without spot or wrinkle.
Amen.
And then when you all have and all have done the best of their service, and he comes in and says, well done, but then that tribulation period is coming. So Faith Bible, stay on the battlefield. Amen. Stay on the battlefield. Amen. Keep on, but just realize now we've got to roll our sleeves up. Every church that God has left on this side, it's time to roll our sleeves up. We've had it easy in America when it comes to being churches. But now the battle is on.
Amen.
But the good news is God chose you for this. Mm-hmm. So keep on fighting. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much, Pastor Bill. We will now have a selection by FBCC, followed by the introduction of our guest speaker, First Lady Slack.
Come on, clap your hands for Jesus, y'all. Is it okay if we worship just a little bit? Can never get enough worship, amen? Worship can be so strong, it can heal. Can I get an amen? David healed a man, he played so skillfully, amen? This is for your pastor, amen. Complete healing. Get a witness, y'all.
Yes, Lord.
About by name. Ooh. Oh, there's something.
Is anybody a witness up in here?
The introduction of our guest speaker by First Lady Slack, followed by a selection from the Full Gospel Temple Choir, and then the word of the hour will be presented. Praise the Lord, saints. It is a true honor to be invited for your 39th year church anniversary. 39 years is a long time. And it's a blessing that through the pandemic, you still stood strong and you're still going on, and that's truly a blessing. But I'm here to introduce to some and present to others a man of God who loved the Lord.
Amen.
You know, I sit back and I think about what the pastor was talking about this morning, about how the Lord, those who he loved, he chastened. And sometimes, you know, when you're being chastened, it doesn't feel good. The word of God does chasten you. Mm-hmm. You know, I was a very hard-headed child, and my mom chastened me a lot. And I look back to this day now, I went back and I thanked her for it.
Amen.
But what the man of God is going to preach to you is what we need to hear.
Amen.
During these times and this day, we were talking about how evil it is and how Satan is running so rampant. We need to hear a true word of God, a teaching. We need to hear something that's going to put Satan to flee. It's only by the word of God who's going to keep Satan off you. And this man of God who will preach the true word of God, not sugarcoat it nor water it down, because he loved God's word.
Amen.
He loved God's people. I'm introducing to you a father, a grandfather, a great-grandfather,
Amen.
And a loving husband.
Amen.
None other than Pastor John Henry Slack.
Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
It's good to be here.
Amen.
Thank God for the opportunity to be in your midst. Thank God most of all for Jesus,
Amen.
Our Lord and our Savior.
Yes, Lord.
He's everything.
Mm-hmm.
We just thank you for thanking enough of us to put us on your program. Amen. Count it as a privilege and an honor to be here. 39 years is a long, long time. And we're looking for you all to do 39 more.
Amen.
We thank God for you. Thank God for your wonderful pastor, Pastor William and his wife and congregation and all of the rest of the ones that make up this number. These great men of God,
Amen.
Men of the cloth, and thank God for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
The Lord is worthy
mm-hmm.
to be praised.
Yes, he is.
I'm not going to read but just this one verse. Well, where I'm going to start it, rather.
Go ahead, Slide.
Just going to read this one verse right now so you all can sit down and rest yourself and relax and take in the Word of God.
Amen.
Okay, your theme is a wonderful one. The church, God's chosen people.
Mm-hmm.
Not the devil's chosen people, but God's chosen people. That emphasizes something.
Amen.
And let me know that you don't belong to Satan.
Mm-hmm.
So the scripture comes from 1 Peter, the 2nd chapter, and the 9th verse.
Mm-hmm.
He said, but ye are a chosen generation,
mm-hmm.
a royal priesthood.
Mm-hmm.
And holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. You may be seated.
Amen.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Lord.
I tell you, I feel like Pilate. I can't find no fault in it. Because he's worthy
mm-hmm.
to be praised.
Yes, he is.
The church, God's chosen people. You know, the Lord's people are described as a chosen people.
Mm-hmm.
Those who are received him are highly privileged. Did y'all know that? You somebody special. You God's special breed. He didn't just do this because he wanted to show off. He did this because he cared.
Mm-hmm.
He cared about the whole world. As reading, God so loved the world
mm-hmm.
that he gave his only begotten son. And he know we wasn't going to do right.
Mm-hmm.
He know we wasn't gonna ever do right. He already knew it. Jesus was in the plan from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
But he had to show you that you couldn't stand on your own, that you couldn't live this life like you're supposed to on your own. That's when he made it by grace.
Mm-hmm.
And you know that's a shame?
Mm-hmm.
Everybody in this world got to be saved by God's grace.
Mm-hmm.
Salvation ain't nothing you work for. Salvation is a gift. That's what grace is.
Yes, sir.
Something you didn't deserve, something you didn't work for. It's a gift from God. And that's a shame. All of the people, billions of people in this world,
mm-hmm.
nobody was able to walk the walk
mm-hmm.
and talk the talk. But you hear some testimony, you think people is Jesus themselves. And probably just got through eating certs or something to keep the alcohol back. Oh, yeah, I've been there. Oh, yes, indeed. Everybody ain't real. But let me tell you, I'm telling you today, take it from me. Take this serious.
Mm-hmm.
Because Jesus is coming back soon.
Yes, he is. Yes,
this ain't going to last forever.
Mm-hmm.
See, that this ain't not a Trump's world. He might own the Congress and all those people, but he don't own the earth.
Amen.
But the Bible said the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Everybody that dwells down here belong to him. He going to show that man something. Oh, he going to show him something. I remember George Wallace. Sick dogs on people. Fire hoses. And if I ain't mistaken, he died in a wheelchair. But you know one thing? The man has sense. He had sense enough to accept Jesus. Well, this boy, he walk around here just mocking God's word and God's people. But he don't know we somebody. And the Bible let us know, don't touch not my anointed. Don't do my prophet no more. So we don't realize who we're talking to when you're talking to some people that somebody don't highly testify. Somebody don't highly dance in the spirit. Somebody might not speak another tongue, but they still know Jesus. So you don't know who God's anointed is. It ain't all the time in the pulpit. God's anointed can be right here. Somebody that don't hardly say a word. Somebody that don't do nothing but just say, thank you, Jesus. And hear a testimony and say, pray for Sister Sue and help her. But the thing what we're talking about today is God's chosen people. That's wonderful. See, we got to realize that those who believed him are highly privileged. You somebody. Don't let nobody belittle you and put you down. You God's chosen people. You somebody. You know what he say? You chosen generation, a royal priesthood. Who could have a privilege more higher than that? You can do the job that the priest did. But see, you don't have to have him no more. You ain't got to go in this little room like some nominations still doing and tell him all your business, because that man might be in a worse shape than you are. You can go to Jesus for yourself.
Amen.
That publican say he wouldn't even look up in the heaven. He should have put his head to the wall there and said, Lord, help me. Have mercy on me, a sinner. This is what we got to do. We ain't no better than nobody else. No, people talking about people, slandering people and all this stuff, and knowing the thing, they're helping that person get straight, and they on their way to hell. God don't play it. He's serious. He's very serious. See, all true Christians are chosen generation. Everybody. From the small to the greatest. See, they're all make one big family. So we are a body of believers.
Yes, sir.
Our called out body of believers. Chosen by God, appointed by God. See, all of the disciples were chosen by God. Peter didn't choose Jesus. Jesus called him. He said, follow me. And then he told Matthew and John and all of them. He told them to follow me. That means he called them.
Amen.
They didn't have no, we talking about, well, I got tired of the world and I came to the, no, you didn't. No, indeed, you came to your senses, just like the prodigal son did. One that wanted to eat hog food. Oh, my God, I've been in bad shape, but I ain't never want to eat hog food. I used to raise hogs. Yeah, so I'm an ex-sharecropper. I've been here a long time. People talking about they make $10, $15, $20 an hour. I used to work for $3 a day. Talking about some hour.
That was $2.50.
Yeah. $15 and $20 a week. When I came out here to got a job at the Sands Hotel, I had never seen that much money. $100 and some in 2 weeks? No, I tell you. That was something. See, first of all, they are special people. We don't realize who we represent. And we people that belong to a holy God. And so if you belong to a holy God, that means you got to be holy.
Amen.
He said, be you holy for I am holy. See, we got to quit playing around and get down to business. People need a light to shine on them. He said, let your light so shine that people can see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. See, the thing about it, we talking about what the world is doing. We ain't living nothing. People need to be drawn to Christ. Some mothers ain't living nothing before their daughters. Some fathers ain't living nothing before the sons. That's the reason they can't be men. In my household, you got the man up. I was taught that. You be a man. My mother said, if you don't be a man, say, a man, I'll kill you. I didn't raise no little flunkers. She didn't call me that, but she called me something different, worse than that. She said, you better be a man. You better be a man. See, they didn't play then. But now we so sophisticated, we don't chastise children no more. But God chastises us. I just show you something is wrong with us up here. We listen to all of the television thing, all of the internet, and child developments and all this junk. I ain't saw a child that's born that don't need to be chastised. Y'all know what I'm talking about? God said he chasing everybody that come before him because he love them.
Amen.
That's the reason they're going out there in the street getting run over because we say, oh, just sit back there a little while. No, you put something on him. He won't go in the street no more. I got enough whooping for the whole family. That's when I came out so healthy. She didn't play no. She didn't play no game. Sure didn't. God is an awesome God.
Amen.
See, we different from common people of the world. We can't act like other people. We can't do what other people do. We can't go where other people go. See, we got to leave Smokey Robinson on the strip where he belongs. See, the Bible says we done came out of darkness. See what I'm talking about? We don't serve the world no more. Can't get out there and cut a secret. Fella told me, he's a hush out there. He said, man, he says more Christians out there. That's the reason the unsaved people can't get no seats. The ladies can't buy no studs for the ill, because the men wearing all of them. You got to come out of the world. If Jesus was here, he wouldn't wear none. I don't care how you look at it. It's right all by itself. And we better pray and ask God, say, Lord, I want to look like you. I don't want to look like the world. You act like the world, look like the world. You are in the world. Can't draw nobody like that. You're in the ditch. How you gonna get somebody else out of the ditch? Because you can't get yourself out. We got to put up a shut up. It's time out for foolishness. See, the church now is entertaining. That ain't what people need. People need deliverance. They need the word of God.
Yes, sir.
Come out the cheer and need. Oh, they got to go somewhere where they can be entertained. The Lord said, you hide, you say, you plant that word. You put it on them, and you put it on the doorpost, and you teach them day and night. That's what they need. They can pick it up. You see how easy they operate those computers? How easy they operate their cell phone? They can learn the word the same way. Too many young teenage pregnancies and all this stuff, and with these no good, these young fellas ain't no men. They don't know how to be a man. They're scared to be a man. I told him, I said, you wasn't scared when you were, you know, messing around. I don't want to hear it. Take care of your children. I'll get sick of spending all my money on them. You take care of them. To my granddad and all this stuff. No, we don't need that kind of junk. See, the thing about it, we got to come out from among people that's doing evil. You can't hang around with people that ain't living godly. Y'all know what I'm talking about?
Amen.
Some people in the church is a bad influence.
Yes, sir.
The Bible said if a person, man, walk on disorderly, you ain't supposed to keep company with him. That's what the word of God says. See, you got to save your own soul from this untoward generation. You can't care what your friends doing. That's why we part company at, because I ain't going to hell for nobody. I wouldn't go to hell for mama. Y'all know what I'm talking about? But people don't care. They don't care about nobody. It's a mess now. See, we could never be what we're supposed to be unless the Lord give us grace and mercy.
Amen. Amen.
You can't do it on your own. See, the Lord sanctified us. That means he called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. So you got to look at people like the Apostle Paul. Mm-hmm. Paul was almost he was a terrible fellow, persecuting the saints.
Mm-hmm.
But God chose him.
Yes, sir.
Called him out of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
Ananias said, I don't know if I should go and talk to him or anything. He said, don't worry about him. He's a chosen vessel.
Yes, sir.
He said, he's going to suffer many things for my name's sake.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to realize Paul was called. He was chosen by God. He didn't choose God.
Amen.
God chose him. He didn't even know who he was. He thought he was doing God a favor by killing the saints. He loved the Lord, but he didn't know who he was.
Mm-hmm.
Some of us that have been church now don't know who Jesus is. He's your Lord. He's your Savior. He's the one that put breath in you in the morning, you wake up. He's the one that calls you to walk around,
mm-hmm.
calls you to be in your right mind.
Yes.
You can be going home and you can lose your mind and you don't even know where you live at. That's how quick it can go.
Yes, yes.
And little old man sprouting around, a number of little 180 pounds of dirt. I just listen to ex-President Trump sometimes. I feel sorry for him.
Yeah, me too.
Because you're talking about an ignorant man. Oh, my God. How could any Christian in this world tell me I'm going to vote for somebody like that? How? I can't see it. And people now tell me I'm for him. If I had 1,000 votes, I'd put 1,000 votes against him. I'd rather see he ain't fit to be dog catcher. It's a disgrace. Look what the man, he don't love nobody. He hates blacks. Well, look what he called the football players. SOBs. Didn't he call them that? Ain't nobody said nothing. He said that. He ain't no good riding or walking, but God said he got his number. And he's going to pay, sure as I'm standing here, he's going to pay. The Bible say, whatsoever man sow, so shall he reap, and I don't care who he is. George Wallace reap, Nixon reap, Hitler reap. He ain't gonna get away. So don't never think that he ain't gonna pay. But we moving right along. Now we're looking at Peter and all of those people, John and all of them. They was fishermen when Jesus called them. Peter didn't just come up and say, well, I'm going over here and serve the Lord. No, the Lord called Peter.
Amen.
He said, follow me. I want to make you fishermen of men. And that's what he did. You got to follow Jesus. But some people don't want to follow leadership. That's the reason God ain't going to never call them to do nothing.
Amen.
If you ain't a good follower, I guarantee you ain't getting back here. Or if you get back here, you ain't called by God. And that's a bad thing to do, be in a place where God didn't even ordain you to be. Ain't appointed to nothing. Come on, well, my pastor did this, my pastor. If you wrong, you're going to answer to God. That's when you got to be careful. Oh, Paul told him, don't lay hands suddenly on no man. Don't you appoint and man up that man to something here, he just got saved. Woman can't pass by and by him. You know what I'm talking about? He need to be delivered. It don't do a lustful man or a lustful woman no good to get married. That do not cure lust. You got to be delivered from lust.
Amen.
Because if you do marry one like that, you better not get sick. Come on, get out of the hospital and go in your bedroom and somebody else might be there. I know what I'm talking about. A lustful person is just lustful. Everybody they see. It don't matter how old, how young. People mess around with people 5 and 6 years old. Do you know they need to be shot? What do a 5-year-old baby know? Lord, I could take a whoop and change their mind. Oh, my goodness. I could whoop until I get tired. And when I rest, I'll whoop them some more. See, but let me tell you one thing. God chose us, you and me. We didn't choose ourselves.
Yes, he did.
Let's go to the book of John, because I'm going to prove everything. I ain't going to tell you nothing that ain't in this Bible. John 15 and 16. It's in you because God had to get them straight. They thought they was doing something. But they didn't choose him. He chose them. Look what he said here. John 15 and 16. He said, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and then I ordain you. That means I appointed you. You know what I'm talking about? I call you. First, he called you out of darkness. Some of us ain't got no business doing nothing yet. He told Peter, he said, when you converted, then you strengthen your brother. People trying to strengthen people and they ain't strengthened. Babies trying to preach this gospel. Babies trying to run churches. A baby gonna do baby things. But pause, when I was a child, I thought like a child. That means you got people not doing everything. The church done became, some of them become the entertainment capital of the world. Jesus didn't have a choir, didn't even have a band, he didn't even have a soloist. Peter couldn't sing. Matthew couldn't sing. He preached the word. People need the word of God. Jesus said, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. We getting away from that. It's a shame. Don't nothing deliver you but the word.
Amen.
He said, you're clean through the words I've spoken unto you. People ain't doing it right now. Teach these little children the word. You're going to put the word. You're going to study the Bible today. Give me a scripture. Say your prayers before you get in here and eat this food. Say your prayers when you get home from school.
Amen.
Say your prayers before you go to sleep. Put them back doing that. And it'll help them. Because they need help now. He said, but I've chosen you and ordain you that you should go and bring forth fruit and that your fruit should remain. And whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it unto you. God wants to help us.
Amen.
Jesus chose his disciples one by one. He chose all of us. All of you today here are chosen vessels. You're not here by chance. You're not here by luck. You're here because God ordained you. He appointed you. And you got some job to do, and everybody ain't called back here to preach. I ain't never saw so many preachers in my life, so many vans. Some people ain't cleaned up yet, y'all. They ain't delivered. Some get back here just to look at the girls. And then some get up there just to strut their strut. Yeah, try to tempt men or something. That's what I'm talking about. It don't make no sense. We need to do this thing right. Because your children is depending on you. You need to set the best example that you can from, because the school is done corrupted them. Other children done corrupted them. The television corrupted them. They ain't got a chance unless you do something.
Amen. Amen.
So you got to live holy.
Yes, sir.
So they can learn how to live holy and they can realize they got to be holy because God is holy. That's what we got to do. We got a job to do. We got a job to do. It ain't no time to play. It's time to get serious. You love your children. God want to see all these families together. He want to see you together with your children, with your grandchildren, with all of your brothers and sisters. So you got to live this thing right. Amen. So they can be drawn to Jesus. Amen. And we can do it. Mm-hmm. All you got to do is just put that mess aside. Mm-hmm. Oh, let me tell you another thing. All true servants of Christ are royal priesthood.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
That's something. Royal priesthood as believers. We've been made kings and priests. Mm. Ain't that something? Kings and priests. You got power to get down and go to the Lord by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need the preacher. You don't need your wife. You don't need your husband. All you need to do is just be sincere. Say, Lord, help me.
Yes, Lord.
I ain't been living right. I got a daughter in there, and she wandering around. Because I ain't living right.
Mm-hmm.
I got a son that ain't a man because I ain't being a man. One fella told me to read, and he beat his wife because his daddy beat his mother. He said, I thought that's what you're supposed to do, Pastor. I said, what? He said, yeah, she stomped her foot. When he walked in that door, if that fool wasn't ready or whatever, he'd slap her down. And that's what he do to us. I said, son, you won't live long as your daddy. I said, there's a little finger here that can pull a trigger of a 9mm. It can pull the trigger of a 357 Magnum. I said, you better watch that. Don't do what your dad did because your dad was wrong. That ain't love. That's not love at all. Let's go to the book of Revelation. We're going to go to the first chapter because we just say it is a royal priesthood, so we got to prove that. You got to prove everything. Show my people, he said, no transgression and sin. You people need to know now. But they ain't going to take your word. Old Pastor Slack said this, but I don't know what he's talking about. He ain't showed me nothing, so I ain't got to do it. This is what he said here. Revelation 1 and 6. The Bible said, and had both made us kings and priests unto God and his Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. See, we like Christ himself,
mm-hmm.
are both kings and priests,
mm-hmm.
a royal priesthood. He makes his church and his people kings to his Father for his glory. Did y'all know that? We're somebody, y'all. As kings, see, we govern ourselves, and then we conquer Satan through the power of God. That means he told in the book of Ephesians, put on the whole armor of God,
mm-hmm.
that you might be able to withstand the fiery darts of the wicked.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't say fight. He said put it on that you can stand. You're supposed to take everything the devil is out. But now they got on the internet, you're supposed to fight your way out. Do you know you ain't no match for Satan? Who defeated him? Nobody. You go out there and try to fight him and see what happened to you. See, you got to realize you got to get your anointed and get your power from in here,
mm-hmm.
from the word of God,
mm-hmm.
not from that mess there, because whoever owned that sometime ain't even saved. And they're telling you what to do.
Mm-hmm.
Podcasts or whatever they call it. Some of them backslid. Know a few on that now and left church and talked about everybody else. And now they don't know trying to talk about everybody else. Well, when you sin and don't confess, let me show you one thing. You done lost fellowship with the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You ain't got no fellowship, so you can't prophesy to me.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
You can't tell me nothing about what thus said the Lord. Because I got something for you. If you don't get your house in order, your candlestick going to be moved.
Yes, sir.
You better come back to the Lord. That's what you need to do. But people now, they prophesying crazy. Oh, brother, Lord showed me this and told me that. And I ain't been to church in 2 months. Talked about everybody in the church. Lied on everybody. You know that people lie on the pastor now just because they can. They used to feel the man of the cloth. They don't know more.
No, sir. No, sir.
They'll talk about him, his wife, his children, his mother, and everybody else. Yeah. People ain't got no respect. And that person watch for your soul. Do you know that's a heavyweight thing? He can intercede for you. God might want to do this and do that. Sometimes he can intercede and say, Lord, just have mercy on him.
Have mercy.
Moses did it.
Yes, sir.
God was going to kill a whole bunch of them. He said, I'm going to make me a similitude of people like you, Moses. Moses said, Lord, don't do that. But what would the Egyptians say? What would the parasites say? They would say, you done got them over here and couldn't contain them. And you know what the Lord did? He changed his mind. And got back, they still wanted to stone him. Because they had the fish and the cantaloupes over there in Egypt. Enslaved. And they mad because they didn't have all the nice foods. We don't want this manna. That's food from heaven. And then it gave them quail. They didn't want that. Ate themselves to death and just greedy and just got sick. And it's a shame. Just greedy. Ate so much that they just got sick. Boy, I tell you, we something, man. We just ain't no good, is we? Now, that's tell the truth. We might as well tell the truth, stand straight. We ain't no earthly good. But God, that's a good God. You know what? What we don't realize, what that really means, saints.
Yes, sir.
God has enabled us now. See, we used to have to get the priest to go in the Holy of Holies. We don't have to do that no more. You can go in there yourself.
Amen. Amen.
And offer up sacrifices and praises to Jesus Christ on your own.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm talking about? You don't need the priesthood no more. Because you priests of your own, you can go and petition God by your lonely self. You can get saved without being in a church. I tell people you don't have to wait till you get to church the next day. You might not see nobody. You can get saved. All you got to do is just believe in Jesus Christ. Amen. Believe in the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Admit you're a sinner. Amen. Confess and repent. Amen. That's all it takes. Amen. We make it so hard. Yeah, we got to take them and we got to train them. Ain't got nothing to do with people training people. But that ain't for your salvation. The New Convoy Club do not save you. That don't save you one, but you go in there, unsaved devil, and come out unsaved devil. Just like baptism. People sort of put so non. I believe, I respect it. But it's an ordinance. It don't save you. I baptize people because they are already saved, not to save them. People got all, they're all mixed up. Oh, yeah, yeah, you got to do this. If you ain't baptized in the name of Jesus, you ain't baptized as you ain't saved, you ain't, they've got to be joking. And if you have a situation where you can't get baptized, you're going to heaven because Jesus told the thief on the cross, the day you'll be in paradise with me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He ain't no partiality person. If I don't have opportunity to baptize a person and that person die tomorrow, he going to heaven.
Amen.
Because Jesus told the thief, he said, you shall be with me in paradise. Today, he said.
Today.
Not tomorrow, but today. Let's go a little bit further. Now, what we said a few minutes ago, God called us to be a holy nation. Mm-hmm. All Christians, wherever they are, compose of one holy nation, mm-hmm. one body of called out believers.
Yes, sir.
Y'all know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. I don't care about no denomination. God ain't thinking about no denominations. Come on, oh yeah, I'm Baptist, I'm Pentecostal, I'm this and I'm that. He ain't thinking about that mess. Well, here's our Pastor John Slack. He ain't going to call me Pastor John Slack. He's going to say John. John the Baptist, he said John. He didn't say Apostle Paul or Apostle Peter. He said Peter or Paul. Titles don't mean nothing to him.
Amen.
And we always want to get something big by our name. Yeah, we pastor, doctor, evangelist, all everything else before that. Ain't that something? That little person in heaven that ain't never got in the pulpit, that ain't testified but two times in their life, might get up there and get drowned with all of the trinkets and all of the crowns and everything. That ain't what God looking for. He's looking for somebody that's going to obey him. Yes, sir. See, it's a blessing when you obey. It's a curse when you disobey.
Yes, sir.
Now we planting seeds everywhere. This is your seed to plant. Right here. You got to send no $1,000 to no man or woman to do this. You can go to Jesus yourself. If you give, you're going to be blessed. It's a blessing in paying your tithe.
Yes, sir.
So you can't be God-given. We letting people just fool us right before our eyes. Well, yeah, I had this. When I planted a seed, I had this. Let me show you one thing. When you pay your tithe, you plant your seed. That's what it is. We're going to give to somebody else's ministry, and you can't even get them to come to the hospital. Give it to other people. Yeah, your church falling in. Pastor's pants tore up. Won't buy the poor man a meal. That's a shame to do people like that. But we hung up on that. Yeah, no, I'm sending my money. I'm going to, you know, I've been to TD Jakes Church. I've been to this. But let me tell you one thing. I bet you this church is just as important, or probably more. He might come back for Bible Christian Center. He might not go to that big old cathedral. Because he might have not never been in there. see that, that's the thing that we don't look at, ain't it? Probably ain't never been in there. That's amazing. So you got to realize, saying, God ain't for that kind of mess. The devil will fool you and deceive you.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? That's all he do.
That's all he do.
He's a liar. Jesus say he's the father of lies. You can't believe nothing he say.
Amen.
Because he ain't going to never tell you what's right. All wrong, that's a blessing from God. Okay, we're going a little bit further. We're going to leave Revelation right quick, and we just about through. Because I know y'all got it. There's no doubt about this. There's going to be some changes tomorrow. Yeah. I feel it coming. There's no doubt about that. There's going to be some changes tomorrow. Somebody going home and say, you know what I'm going to do with that man say? See, Christians, like I said, wherever they are, they're a holy nation.
Mm-hmm.
And they're one nation. See, they collected to the head. They collected to the body. See, Christ is the body, the head of the church. He's the head. I ain't the head, Pastor William ain't the head. These pastors ain't the head. He's the head. We just servants doing what he told us to do. That's all that is. I tell people, well, Pastor, like, where's all your members? I say, right here. Y'all don't nobody belong to me. No, indeed. I ain't trying to claim God's possession. I might act crazy and look a little crazy, but I ain't crazy. I ain't gonna be no fool. No, I ain't gonna do that. So where we going now? Let's go to the book of 2 Timothy right quick. Because all Christians, wherever they are, they belong to Jesus. And we are a holy nation. Let's go to 2 Timothy. See, you got to realize that God made this thing plain and clear. 2 Timothy 1, chapter 1, and we're going to read just one verse, verse 9. See, it's in the Bible. What he said? He said, who had saved us and called us with a what kind of calling? A holy calling. not according to our works. See, because some just gonna barely make it in. They ain't have no work, no crown or nothing. But thank God you made it in. Thank God you made it in. That's the main thing. Well, the preacher told me all the time, he said, Pastor, like he said, who you want to see when you get there? Yeah. Mother, your father? I said, yeah, I want to see them too, he said. And but one person I want to see before I see everybody. He said, I want to see Jesus, so I make sure that I'm in the right place. If I see Jesus, I know I'm in the right place. So I changed that. I changed that. Okay, 2 Timothy 1:9. He said, who had saved us, call us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace. That's the reason you were called, for God's purpose and God's grace. It's a gift. You know we didn't deserve it. And we know we don't deserve it now. We'd run around and talk about how holy we is and how sanctified we are, but we know we ain't right. That's reason some of us work up at 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning. Because the Lord let you know that you ain't where you're supposed to be. And get on your knees and pray. Y'all know what I'm talking about? But we get in the church. Oh, we Jesus himself. Ain't that something? That's amazing. We're going to say the same thing Job said. Job was boasting to all his friends and all of the ones that were talking about it. And when God came down and spoke to him out the world, you know what he said? I'm vile. I ain't no good. That's what we gonna say. I ain't no good, God. I was just lying. Please forgive me. I was just trying to make myself look big. He know. Just get it right. That's all. God can help you. I don't want to be like this no more. I want to be delivered. I want to be a light. I want to help the church. Not break it down. See, the devil got something in there that want to destroy it. Everything. Talk about everything. Every day something wrong. Somebody done messed with them. Somebody done did this or somebody this. But they don't bother nobody. The devil will use you.
Amen.
Because the first person you need to get straight is you. Amen. When you look in the mirror, who the hell are you trying to see how to comb? When you look in the mirror brushing your teeth, whose teeth you seeing how to brush? Yours. Well, that's what people need to do. Amen. Clean up their own house.
Yes, sir.
Everybody else is going to be on their way to heaven. They're going to be on their way to hell. Because their house is going to be dirty and everybody else is going to be clean. Mm-hmm. See, it's a shame. People just don't know. But he said, but according to his purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began. Now, you know that's something. See, God is holy. And we got to be holy also. Amen. Because we serve a holy God. See, Christ, like I said, is the head of the body, right? Which is the church. A call out body of believers. Ain't that something? See, Saint, we are... We're God's peculiar people. Amen. We're special. We're privileged. Mm-hmm. We ain't just know anybody. We privileged. Amen. See, we are special people, and God wants us to make sure that we act like that. Mm-hmm. We walk like that. You can't do what you want to do no more. Mm-hmm. You're not your own. You've been bought with a price. Amen. You can't go where you want to go no more. So you got to give. You got to try to help some other people. Some people can go out there right now and drink a whole pint of alcohol and won't get drunk. Another person can go out there and drink two drinks and go home and jump on his wife and the chair and run the dog out. You know what I'm talking about? So the reason you don't do these things is because you don't want to be a bad example to other people.
Amen.
Some people go out there, take $20, $30 and gamble and go home. Some people go out there and lose a paycheck. So the reason you don't do it because you don't want to be a bad example to nobody else. And that person see me, well, Pastor Slack was doing it, they ain't gonna never stop. They got excuse. He doing it, got to be all right. So you got to refrain yourself from doing these things so you can have people following Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Do you know every soul you mess up, maybe you're going to have to get them counted? Huh? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, you're going to get them counted. So I don't want no blood stain on my name. See, I done did enough and been in enough trouble. So I ain't told all of my testimony because don't nobody tell everything. You got some skeletons in the wall, too. Yeah, you got some skeletons in the closet. Everybody don't tell everything. You tell people what you want them to know. Now, if they found out something else, now that's a different thing. But you ain't gonna never tell it all. It's something you're holding back. We might as well tell the truth and stay in church. It's it. Ain't nobody told everything about themselves. No, and still ain't did it. But God got a screen, I believe.
Yes, sir.
And you're gonna look at yourself. He said, now this is what you didn't never tell nobody, John, but I know. Don't nobody know this but me and you. Let's go to the last chapter we threw. We go into the book of 2 Corinthians, and we're going to go to the 6th chapter. We got to get things straight now.
Yes, sir.
We're going to bring it home, because I see, I know. I can tell there's some dedicated people here. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to tell you one thing. If you got a problem, you got a situation that you can't kick, you can't get rid of, Jesus got the power.
Amen.
I couldn't stop drinking. Mm-hmm. I couldn't stop gambling. I said, Lord, I need you to help me. Smoking cigarettes, just one behind each other. I said, I need you to help me. And you know what? I ain't had a drink since then. Since 1977.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, I've been tempted. Went out to exclusive restaurants, you know, they give you this dinner wine, you know. They bought the dinner wine on the table. I said, did you have a 7-Up in the thing? He said, oh, man, this wine is a good expense. I said, no, I drank 7-Up. You can have that. See, I know I was delivered when my mother died, and I didn't take a drink. And I went on the outside. I said, thank you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
I know I'm delivered.
Yes, sir.
Because if I didn't drink behind Mattis, like, wasn't nothing in this world going to ever make me drink.
Amen.
God delivered me.
Amen.
Because I couldn't afford it. Now, do you know how much alcohol costs? You know how much it costs you to gamble? Cigarettes, $5 and $6 a package? I couldn't afford it. I wouldn't have nothing. My wife would be riding in a smoky or something. See what I'm talking about? I'd be in bad shape. What we saying? 2 Corinthians, right? 2 Corinthians, 6th chapter. 6th chapter of 2 Corinthians. And we're gonna go to the 16th verse. Now listen to this. We're going home now. And what agreement had the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God, as God had said, I will dwell in them and walk in them. And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Mm-hmm. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be you separate, said the Lord. Touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. And I will be a father unto you. You shall be my sons and daughters, said the Lord God Almighty. See, God and idols don't mix, y'all. Just like oil and water, don't mix. Idols are rivals with God for his honor. Did y'all know that? Saints, we got to separate ourselves from the world. Remember, we've been called out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Yes, sir.
You can't keep on doing the same thing that you was doing before the Lord called you out of darkness.
Amen.
See, we you can't go back to the same thing. I don't care how bad you want to dance when that music come on and you used to cut up, you know. You got to keep them feet on the ground, said Lord. Keep my feet still. Let me dance the holy music. Mm-hmm. See what I'm talking about? Because you're cheering watching it. I saw Dad and Mama in there. You know what they was doing? I peeked through the door. Boy, they was dancing and drinking. Well, guess what they going to do? They going to be a hypocrite when they get out. Mm-hmm. They going to dance and drink. And it's going to be your fault.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you miss out on going to heaven, and when you get to hell, you know what that child going to say? Mama or Dad, the reason I'm here is because of you. Mm-hmm. That'll be a terrible thing. Come out for more now. God is good.
Amen. Give the man of God another hand clap. Like you said, we at the point now is playtime is over. Every night he wakes me up to remind me of that. A lot of people think because we stand here, we got it all together. We don't. We trust God to give us what to give you. And I'm giving you opportunity to come to him. You have to have a relationship with Christ Jesus for any of that he said to apply to your life. A lot of us, we come to church, we go every week, we on Bible study, Sunday school, and really don't know who Jesus is. And some go to church called Grandmama went, and Granddaddy went, and Uncle went, and if I didn't go to church, I couldn't eat in my house. But one day, Christ called me. And like Pastor Slyke said, you don't choose him, he chose you.
Amen.
Most people in Vegas would not be in church if God didn't choose them. There's so much other things to do, but I'm asking you today, if you don't have a relationship with Christ, come. If he pulled up outside and say, those that know me, get in. Could you get in? Or would you have to go back and take care of something? While you go back, you miss the bus. Come. And if you don't want to do it today in here, when you get home, ask God to forgive you for what you didn't do and what you did do. And according to his scripture, he'll forgive you. He don't ask you where you've been or what you did. He accepts you just like you are. And hopefully he'll give you the courage next time you come to the house, you'll stand before men, women, boys, and girls, and tell them that you belong to him. He said, if you be ashamed of me before men, I'll be ashamed before my father. You dance in the streets, change your partner, come dance with Jesus. And when you dance with him, he don't talk about you. If you're hurt, he'll cover you and comfort you. That's what he offers to you. And if you have that, God bless you. If you don't, when you get home, get it. Because you're looking for tomorrow that may not come. Understand that. Somebody right now is hoping that they could speak, could walk and see, and they can't do either. But God can heal you.
Yes, he can.
If you don't have Jesus, you're blind anyway. You may have 20/20 vision, but you're blind. You can't hear. And your heart ain't right without Jesus, because he's the heart regulator. So take my advice. If you don't have it right, you're scared to do it now, get it right when you get home. God bless you.
Amen.
Feeling? I feel good.
Amen.
I don't know about you. I am a teacher at heart, and that was a good lesson.
Amen.
So, Pastor Bell, I got my notes too. I'll be going home and doing some further studying and transcribing so that seed is further planted in my heart. And I love the challenge that Pastor Slack gave us, or John, as he said. Lord don't care about no titles. He said it, y'all. You heard that. So the challenge is, what changes are you making tomorrow?
All right.
What changes are you making tomorrow? If you don't wake up, if you don't go to bed tonight and ask the Lord and make those changes, your walk in here was in vain. Don't go to sleep on that, because you just heard a very powerful word.
Amen.
And on top of that, you were given scripture to back it up.
Amen.
So wake tomorrow and ask yourself, what changes am I making today? Because I know I am special.
Amen.
So at this time, I first want to remind our members of their annual assessment fee for $50. Make sure you, if you've not taken care of that already, do an offering. Please do that before you leave today, or see Sister Clara Blaylock before you leave in regards to that. But also, we want to thank everyone for their attendance. We just want to say thank you. And I do want to acknowledge, we do know that Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church was among our churches we welcomed into our sanctuary, as well as Mount Jamerson. So thank you very much, everyone. At this time, I'm going to turn it over back to the pulpit. Is everybody ready to go home and serve the Lord? Oh, also, oh, there we go. We just got that reminder. Also, remember, there is dinner prepared for you in the back to go. It's already hot and ready. All you got to do is take it and go on home, take your shoes off, and get your Bible out and eat and study. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Let's give God a hand of praise. Amen. Let's give Pastor Slack a warm welcome. Amen. In case you didn't know it, Pastor Slack has a unique way of making you smile and whooped at the same time. Yeah, he's good at that. Amen, amen. We thank you for coming, and we thank all the faith and all those that worked daily to put this 39-year church anniversary together. Amen. Give yourself a hand. You did a wonderful job. And to our First Lady, amen, Lula Williams. All the minister of ceremony, my daughter, Nicole, Dr. Nicole Dobbins, amen. We have a new boss. Amen. Amen. Our daughter has been away for a while, and she came home and to further her interest in education and her life. And she's been with us now for a while, and she's here with us, and we thank her for that. But it's not, you know, we've been like free for a long time. But now she come home, we're back in the chicken coop. But we love her for that. We know she's a loving child, and she loves the Lord, and she's good at what she do, and she loves people. And I thank God for that. I want to thank Faith, amen, for being who you are.
Amen.
Amen. Being together, amen. That scripture Pastor Slack read, the next scripture he told them says he wants them to be as one. Amen. If whatever we can get to be as one, that's power.
Amen.
There's unity. There's faith. There's trust. There's deliverance. We get to be one. But he said that in John, I wish you'd be one as me and my Father one. That's how close he wants to be. And I thank you, Faith, for hanging in there through the tough times and the years that we've been here. I've been here 21 years coming this July, man. I thank God for that. And what I've had to deal with. But I had help. I had power. I had people. Those that believe in the same thing that we believe in. Our darling son, Jesus Christ, who is the one that's going to get us through, amen. And I want to make to the youth, we have a youth work program on Saturday morning, and I had some of the youth call me Friday, and I told them, I said, Pastor, are we working today? I said, no, I'm working for my wife today, amen. And I had something to do, but I called some of my workers, and they couldn't come. And I sit down and I said, Lord, I need you to send me some help right now. And lo and behold, three of the youth called. Said, Pastor, you want to work today? Now, if you don't understand that, how powerful God is,
yes,
how you can call on him.
Right.
Now, when I told my wife, I said, well, three of the boys called. She said, but they can't. They won't be able to. I said, listen, whatever God sends you, that's what you use. If we can learn to do that, whatever God sends us,
know he knows what he's doing and use that, amen. They came over and did a wonderful, wonderful job. I want to say that because I told some of the youth that we weren't working. But when they called, when they answered the call from God and called me, right after I prayed, they called. And thank you, Alex, Anthony, and what do we, are they here today? They're in the back. And it worked out because they usually don't get to work, come to work on Saturday because they get engaged in some of the school activities and sports. So they missed some days, but they got to work last this Saturday because God called them to come help me. And I thank you, boys. And my wife, thank you because you did a great job. And she's just happy with what you did for on yesterday. God bless you. And to all you that we have a, from our work program, we have a young lady that one day she called and asked if she come and help. Amen. She came in. And you know what? Ever since she started, she's been in church ever since. She was on the dance team today. Amen. What's her name? What's it?
Amna.
Amna. New addition to us because of what we are doing in Christ. And let me tell you something. Our youth are our future. And we've got to put some time, effort, and economics into our youths. Because the pastor, like I told you, the world is taking them by droves. And we got to put the time, effort, and the money to make it happen. Amen?
Amen.
And I thank God because we have youth here that are really, really striving to become better. And we have some, I think the ones that are putting these, we have a youth program and a what's the, what they have, the one where they do debate, not a debate, trivia. Where they have a Bible trivia team where youth get on there and they try to compete against each other, all in learning more about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But like I told you, we got to begin to really teach them. You know, yesterday, my grandson was supposed to work. And I said, son, you know something? He came up with a little excuse. He had to go do something. I knew it wasn't a real reason. But I said, you know what? In the scripture, it says, if a man don't work, he should not eat. And I said, better still, go get the Bible. Go find it. Because don't believe what I say. Go look, read it for yourself. And what scripture I says in 2 Thessalonians, 3rd chapter. Go read the whole chapter. I said, what did it say? He said, well, it said that if you want something, you have to work. I said, no, no. Understand that. Wanting and eating is two different things. It said, if you don't work, you don't work, you shouldn't eat. Now we need to eat to want something. So get it right. Amen. We thank God for all our youth here. Our new Ayrshire, Larry, amen, is joining the Ayrshire team. God bless him. And we get behind them. They are involved in various activities and sports. We try to go out and participate, amen, in the games when they're playing. Let them know that we want them to do, and we expect them, let them know that we love what they're doing. We go out as often as we can to support them, whatever their engagements are. Whether it's a ball game or whatever they're involved in, we take part in. We have one lady here, Sherelle. 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 It's going to be a ballet dancer one of these days. But I thank God that members went to see her when she performed. And she was surprised that they showed up. They love it when they see us take part in what they're doing. Amen. We want them to come here. We need to go there and support them. So our youth, our future. And if we don't be careful and do what we're supposed to do at what Proverbs 22nd verse, chapter of Proverbs say, train them up when they're young. We can't wait till they get up here. Because the Bible says, if they get old, it's hard to bend and sap when they get old. You got to train when they're young. And my daughter said something a long time ago with her kids. I told y'all this. She used to read when she was pregnant. She used to read storybooks, kid books. I said, nigga, why are you reading? You are... Professor, you're reading story rhymes. She says, I'm reading to my child in the womb. She started training them from the womb up. So start early, and let's put some effort I mean, some real effort into our kids. My wife gets upset with me sometimes because when they work, I pay them. How come you did? Listen, Jesus said, whatever is fair, I'll pay you. And we're trying to teach them how to work. Because when it's in this life, they're going to have to know how to work. If we don't teach them, see, we were taught, amen. We didn't have a chance. We had no choice. We had to work, amen. And we need to teach them that. Like Pastor Flagg said, they can take these computers and these phones and do amazing things with them. And they can't learn a Bible verse? No, come on now. I say that to say this. We love you for coming, and thank you for being with us here on our 39-year chance anniversary. And all those that took part, amen, thank you for blessing us, and we hope we've been a blessing to you. And Pastor Flack, again, I can't never say enough about how you preach and how you make us smile and whoop us at the same time. And I didn't take written notes, but I took a lot of mental notes, amen, from that text, amen. He did a marvelous job. Let's give him another hand. And thank you to all the members. And I'm not saying how old she is, but one of our oldest members, Sister Lewis. And she's probably the most youngest acting one. But she's a joy, and she's also a pain. But we love her because we know she loves the Lord as you love us. Again, thank you for coming. God bless you. We have food prepared for you in the back. We're going to ask Pastor Flack, please come back and say a blessing for the food. And again, thank you very much. Give y'all a big round of applause for coming out and sharing with us on 39-year church anniversary. Amen. To the pastors here, thank you for all you've done. And Pastor Elliott, who couldn't be here today, their building got flooded last night. And they weren't able to be here with us. They couldn't even have service today, but he called and said, gave us our regard. Let's pray for them as they go forward. And my Pastor Stephanie, amen. Let us pray for him as he go through, amen. And my godfather in the spirit, Pastor Henry, and his wife, amen. Sister Henry, thank you. Because he marched us into this church 21 years ago. And we've been here ever since. God bless you. And yes, River Lewis?
No, I was saying.
Oh. But again, thank you all for coming, and God bless you. And if you ever need us in any way you can help you, just let us know. And we'll do our very best to take care of whatever you have to take care of. Amen? Amen. Let's all give God a hand and praise today. Amen. As Pastor Flack come back, we have food for you in the back. And he said, this gold plate. So take your plate, amen. Now, I'm not saying they're going to kill me for this here. Because I'm not saying you have to go. Amen.
That's true.
But if you want to sit down and chat, amen, feel free, amen. But it's designed because of what's going on out here now. We don't know what it is that's happening. There's a lot of more things happening out here. We're trying to keep ourselves safe, amen. Amen. So we're not trying to push you out, amen. We're trying to keep you safe, amen. God bless you and God keep you. Again, thank you very much for coming. We appreciate you so much. God bless you. Here again, our own the whooping, smiling preacher, Pastor Slack.
Stand and be get ready to be dismissed. We thank the Lord for blessing us on this day and Faith Bible Christian Center anniversary. We thank you all for just putting us on your program, and thank you all for opening up your kitchen and supplying food, and we appreciate it. But we wish you all 39 more years.
And we know God is going to make it possible. Don't worry about a thing. If God be for you, who can be against you?
Yes,
and really mean if God be for you, can't nobody be against you.
Yes,
so we thank God for each and every one. Keep on doing what you're doing. Follow your pastor. Because people got to learn how to follow leadership. That's where you get your blessing from. That's where you get your blessing from. If you don't follow, you'll never leave. You never leave because God ain't gonna call you, but you might call yourself, but God don't use that. Let's bow our heads, you all. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we just want to say thank you. Thank you, first of all, for the sheep of your pastor, for this great pastor and Faith Bible Christian Center, and thank you, God, for these other two great men of God and pastors, and praying that you will cover them with your blood too, that you will bless everybody that's at the sound of my voice, that you will put a hedge around them just like you did Job, and don't let no harm or danger come to them. In the mighty name of Jesus, I believe they're thanking, I believe they're praising. We pray that your blessings will be forevermore, that your blessings will be forevermore. Now, dear Lord, we thank you for enabling us to fellowship. Thank you for the food that's prepared. Thank you for the ones that prepared it. Thank you for the one, Lord, that brought it and made it possible, which is Faith Bible Christian Center. And we pray that you will bless them, and we pray that, Lord, that you would look on us and look on the food. And we thank you for the food that we're about to receive. We pray that it bring the proper blessing and nourishment that's necessary for our body function. We'll be so careful to give you all praise and all glory. All thanksgiving belong to you. These things we ask and pray and believe and receive in your holy Son's name. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen. What I say on the what? I say on the all. Watch and pray. Shake hands with your brothers and sisters and say, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Yeah.